العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. أما بعد، we begin by praising Allah Azza wa Jal, Lord of the Alameen, which is mankind, jinn, and everything that exists. And we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his messenger. My dear brothers, I remind everyone again, please the cars. If your car is blocking someone, think about it, because sometimes we block someone and we forget we block them. And inshallah, of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when those three men walked in, the first one sat right next to the Prophet ﷺ as he gave the talk. The one sat at the back and one walked off. Prophet ﷺ at the end of the talk asked, who are those three men? As for the one who moved up and sat close to me, Allah Azza wa Jal moved up to him. And as for the one who got embarrassed and shy and sat at the back, Allah got embarrassed and shy from him. And as for the one who turned around and walked away, Allah Azza wa Jal walked away from him. So try to move up as close as you can. Brothers, please try to move up as much as you can, so we can get the barakah, inshallah, and the reward. Allah Azza wa Jal addressed Dawood one day, the Prophet Dawood alayhi salam. He said to him, O Dawood, if the sinners came to know how much anticipation, love and mercy, how much shawq I had towards them, their joy would be so much so that the limbs of their bodies would be separated. You know when you're happy, when you see a child, he's excited and he's jumping around and he can't sit down? If the sinners, the ones who disobey me, knew how much shawq, how much anticipation and love and mercy I had towards them, their joy would be so much so that their limbs would be separated from their bodies. O Dawood, if this is my shawq, my anticipation, love and mercy towards those who are sin and disobedient, then what must be my mercy for those who love me and obey me? Allah Azza wa Jal is the greatest. He is the most gracious and the most merciful. A person from Bani Israel was a sinner, was an extremely bad man. This man was so bad that the entire city, the entire society turned against him and banished him. They kicked him out of the city. Now he was alone, with no food, with no provision. If he becomes sick, no one was there to look out for him. And he passes away, he dies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends wahi to the Prophet of that time. And he tells him that one of my awliya, one of my beloved close friends have died. So go and wash him, do ghusl on him. Prepare his janazah and go and announce in the village that anyone who prays on him is forgiven. So the people get together and they go to pray on this man. As they reach the man and they're about to pray on him, they realize that's the same man, that evil man that we all turned away and banished him from the city. So the Prophet turns to Allah and he says, Ya Allah, what do you mean by this? What do you mean by this? So Allah Azza wa Jal replies, he was alone, wahid, dhaleel, humiliated, haqeen, insignificant, saw his insignificance all by himself. He had no friend, no relative. And as he got weaker and weaker, he couldn't turn to anyone else. There was no one else, no other door to knock on, no one else to ask for help, no one else to seek refuge with. And in this moment of utter weakness and desolation, he turned to Allah Azza wa Jal and he said, O Allah, if I knew that by punishing me, your greatness will increase, and by forgiving me, your greatness would decrease, I wouldn't ask you to forgive me. But O Allah, knowing that by forgiving me, your greatness will not decrease, and by punishing me, your greatness will not increase, then O Allah, I have no one else to turn to, no other hope but you, no other shelter for me but you, no other direction to turn towards except you. So forgive me. In this condition, this person died. He passed away. In this very condition, he passed away. You know what Allah Azza wa Jal said? Allah Azza wa Jal said to his Prophet that his repentance was so much, his repentance was so great, that he was narrow-minded in asking forgiveness for himself only. If he had asked forgiveness for the entire of mankind, I swear by my might and my majesty, I would have forgiven all of mankind. This is Allah Azza wa Jal, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious, the most merciful. The one who said, who we read every single day when we say Bismillah, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious, the most merciful. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Again and again, the most gracious, the most merciful. The most gracious, the most merciful. وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم. The most gracious, the most merciful. Prophet ﷺ said, Allah states that if the believers knew how severe my punishment was, if the believers knew how severe my punishment was, none of them would ever think that escape hellfire. And if the disbelievers knew how much mercy I had, none of them will ever think they'll enter hellfire. Allah Azza wa Jal is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allah Azza wa Jal is the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah Azza wa Jal is limitless in His mercy, yet to give us an idea, He gives us a hadith that He has 100 mercies. He's limitless, but just to give us an idea, He has 100 mercies. These 100 mercies, out of these 100 mercies, every single drop of water we receive, every morsel of food, every tree that grows, every plant that bears fruit, every breath of air, every heartbeat, every smile we receive and every kind word that is said, every child that is born and every baby which is nurtured and fed and looked after, every prophet sent and every piece of wahi of revelation revealed to mankind, and even a sheep or a ram that raises its leg so its baby can drink from its milk, all of this mercy is one of Allah Azza wa Jalla's mercies. You know what He's left the other 99 for? To forgive us on the Day of Judgment. The other 99 times this mercy is to forgive us on the Day of Judgment. That's why a man comes on the Day of Judgment and his deeds are weighed, his good and bad deeds are weighed. His good and bad deeds are weighed. And they're exactly the same. Oh Allah, please let me find one good deed. I don't want to burn in hellfire. Let me look for one good deed. So Allah Azza wa Jalla tells him, look for a good deed, because today we're going to be dealing with everyone justly. No one is going to be dealt with unjustly. So this man goes to his mother, his father, his uncle, his auntie, his nephew, his niece, his own wife and children, and no one will give him one good deed. We're scared of the same thing happening to us. No way. Leave us alone. We don't even know you. Until he finds a man who has mountains and mountains and mountains of sin as far as the eye can see, and only one good deed. He says, please, it's one good deed. I just need one good deed. And my good deeds will be heavier and I'll be entered into paradise. So this man tells him, look at my sins. I spend my entire life in sin. I've only done one good deed. This one good deed is not going to help me. Look how much sin I've done. Take it and go. So he takes this good deed. He comes back to Allah Azza wa Jal, and his deeds are weighed and his good deeds are heavier than his bad deeds. So Allah Azza wa Jal asked him, but just to show us. He knows, but just to show us. Where did you get this good deed from? He said, I got it from your servant so-and-so. He goes, my servant so-and-so gave it to you? He said, yes. He goes, I'm the most generous. Take his hand and both of you into paradise. Take his hand and both of you into paradise. Allah Azza wa Jal wants to forgive us. Allah Azza wa Jal wants to forgive us. He is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious and most merciful. A man who come on the Day of Judgment, he would have done minor sins and major sins. He's standing in front of Allah being judged for his minor sins. But he's so scared that Allah is now going to judge him after his minor sins, is going to judge him for his major sins. So he's standing there shaking. He's shaking as Allah Azza wa Jal is judging him for his minor sins, but not because of his minor sins, because he's scared Allah is going to judge him for his major sins. When Allah Azza wa Jal finishes judging him for his minor sins, he says, you have been forgiven and all your sins have been turned into hasanat, into good deeds. So the man looks and he says, all his minor sins turned into major sins. 10 seconds ago, what was he doing? He was scared that Allah will judge him for his major sins. When he sees them all turned into hasanat, he'll tell him, Allah, I had some major sins, I'm going to turn them into hasanat as well. Allah Azza wa Jal is the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah Azza wa Jal is the most gracious, the most merciful. He's given us a way out of everything. Of everything. We all hear that the scholars say, if you owe anyone anything, if you've harmed someone, or you've taken money off them, or if you owe someone something, you could never get it wiped off until you give it back. Never. Even a shaheed, if he has a debt and he's killed in the path of Allah, he will be stopped from entering paradise until his debt is paid. But you know what? There's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. A man will come on the Day of Judgment. with mountains and mountains and mountains and mountains of good deeds. And as Allah Azza wa Jalla is judging him, a man will come and he'll say, Ya Rabb, oh Allah, he owes me something. I want it back. So Allah Azza wa Jalla tells this man, give him back his rights. So the man says, Ya Rabb, the world has ended. How am I going to give him back his rights? So Allah Azza wa Jalla tells him, give him from your hasanat. But Ya Allah, I need my hasanat. I don't want to give him any of my hasanat. So Allah Azza wa Jalla tells him, take off his sayyat, take off his bad deeds. But Ya Allah, I do not want to get punished for something I haven't done. In this point, the Prophet ﷺ begins to cry. The Prophet ﷺ begins to cry at his ummah. Look what happened to them. Look at their status. Look at their position. Look where they are. No one cares about no one. Every man for himself. Even if it's something small, he'll come to take his rights. So the Prophet ﷺ begins to cry at how their state is. So Allah sees the Prophet ﷺ crying. So he tells that man who wants to take his rights back, he tells him, look up. So the man looks up and he sees a palace so beautiful, so amazing, that in amazement he turns to Allah and he says, oh Allah, to which prophet does that belong to? It was so great that he said, Ya Allah, to which prophet does that belong to? So Allah Azza wa Jalla replies to him, that's for the one who can afford it. The one who has the price to pay for it. He goes, then, oh Allah, what's the price for it? He goes, you have it. He goes, what is it? He goes, forgive your brother. So it forgives him both of them into paradise. The scholars say that this is for the man who done haram. And then he turned back to Islam. And he owed people some rights, some money, something he owed them. And he tried. He tried and he tried and he tried as much as he can throughout his life to find this man and give him back his rights. He tried and he tried and he tried. He went from place to place. Not Allah, he calls him one dial and turns it off so he doesn't have to give him back whatever he owes him. No, he called. And he asked around, and he went to his parents, and he went to the police station, and whatever he done, he tried in all his power, he tried to get this rights back to his man, and he couldn't. Allah Azza wa Jalla even finds for him a way out on the Day of Judgment. Allah Azza wa Jalla is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Come to Allah Azza wa Jalla one handspan, and he'll come to you two handspans. Come to Allah Azza wa Jalla one arm's length, and he'll come to you two arm's length. Come to Allah walking, and the Lord of the heavens and the earth will come to you running. Just turn to Allah. Just ask for forgiveness. Just ask Allah for forgiveness and He'll forgive you. Cry to Allah, beg to Allah. And Allah Azza wa Jal will take you out of your misery. Grant you a life of bliss and eternal happiness in Jannah. Just turn to Allah. Just turn to Allah Azza wa Jal. We have forsaken Allah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, look at that man who killed 99 men. He killed 99 men. Can you think of a greater sin? 99 men murder. He comes to a worshipper. I've killed 99 men. I want forgiveness. Can Allah forgive me? He goes, no. So he killed him. Made it 100. Now he feels bad again after a little while. He wants forgiveness. So he looks around. He finds a scholar. Can Allah forgive me? I've killed 100 people. Of course. Of course Allah is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious, the most merciful. Allah forgives everything. Just turn to him. He told him the conditions of repentance, he told him what to do and how to turn back from his sinful ways, and he gave him a piece of advice. This city that you are living in is full of haram. It's full of haram, you won't be able to change your ways, so go to another city. There are righteous people, a good environment, and it will help you to turn away from your ways. So this man leaves his city and he's walking on the way, traveling to the other city. On the way he dies. So the angels of mercy come down to take his soul, and the angels of Jahannam, of hellfire, come down to take his soul. He says his mind, he was an evil man who killed 100, and the others say, no, he wanted repentance. So an angel is sent to judge between them, and they finally decide that if he is closer to the city where he's from, he goes to Jahannam. And if he's closer to the city where he's going to, he's from the people of paradise. You know what the hadith narrates? In the hadith, it narrates that Allah Azza wa Jalla from above seven heavens moves the earth over, so He's closer to the people, to the place where He's going, and He is given paradise. Allah Azza wa Jalla is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Look how easy it is to turn to Allah. Look how easy it is to seek to get forgiveness. Look how easy it is to face Allah Azza wa Jalla like the day your mother gave birth to you, sinless. Just turn to Allah and cry, and ask Him to forgive you. The scholars give us a story. It's not a hadith or anything, just a story to let us understand the value of those who turn to Allah, who cry in fear and in repentance to Him. A man who come on a day of judgment, he'll be judged and his sins will be outweighing his good deeds. So he'll be told to be thrown in the hellfire. As the angels grab him and are dragging him to hellfire, a teardrop which he, the eyelash in which the teardrop fell on, bears witness for him, oh Allah, he shed one tear for your sake. So he's forgiven and enters paradise.
No.
The teardrop, the eyelash bears witness for him. Allah's mercy is limitless. Allah's mercy is limitless. Jibreel came to the Prophet ﷺ one day and he said, Ya Rasulullah, the angels write down the actions of your ummah, but they don't write down the tears of your ummah. So the Prophet ﷺ asked, why? Why do you not write down the tears of my ummah? You know what the angel Jibreel replied to him? He said, one tear of regret, of repentance, of fear of Allah Azza wa Jal will wipe out oceans of the fire of hell. So the angels can't even write it down. They can't even write it down. Allah Azza wa Jal, His doors of mercy are always open. Just turn to Him. Ya Ibn Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك ولا أبالي. O son of Adam, if you sin and sin and sin and sin, each and every single one of us in this room sin and sin and sin and sin until we cover the whole of Australia with the blackness of our sin. And then we continue sinning and sinning until Asia and Europe and the Middle East and the entire world and the oceans and the trees and everything is covered by the blackness of our sin. And then we continue to sin and sin and sin and sin until our sins, the blackness of our sins reaches the heavens. And then once, just once you turn to Allah and ask Allah to forgive you, He'll forgive you for all your sins and He would not even care. He would not even matter to Him. He would not even matter to Him. Just turn to Allah Azza wa Jalla. This talk was given a name, and forever received the message, they know what this name was. The name of this talk was, everyone will enter paradise except for he who refuses. Everyone will enter paradise except he who refuses. Why? You know what this statement is? This is a statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He told his companions one day, every one of us, every one of you will enter paradise except for he who refuses. So the companions of Rasulullah turned to him, Ya Rasulullah, who's going to refuse paradise? Who will refuse paradise? You know what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told them? He told them, as for the one who follows the Quran and Sunnah, he has accepted to enter paradise. And as for the one who has rejected the Quran and the Sunnah, he is the one who has rejected paradise. Allah Azza wa Jalla told you how to get to paradise. Allah has made the path clear. He's told us what to do to enter paradise. But we refused. We rejected, we turned away. So on the day of judgment, we reject entering paradise. Look how easy it is to turn to Allah. Look how easy it is to get all your sins forgiven. Look how easy it is for Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive everything you have and give you the highest level of paradise. But we're the ones who are turning away from Allah. We're the ones who are turning away from Allah. Allah is telling you, come to me one handspan, I'll come to you too. Come to me one arm's length, I'll come to you two arm's length. Come to me walking, I'll come to you running. Just turn to Allah. Just turn to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah tells you, from salah to salah, I'll forgive all your sins. People are refusing to pray. From Friday to Friday, I'll forgive all your sins. People are putting work over salah to Jum'ah. From Ramadan to Ramadan, I'll forgive all your sins. What do people do? They spend their days sleeping and their nights hanging out. And then the Eid comes, what do? It becomes a fashion show in front of the mosque and they visit each other, mixed music, mabar shul, so on and so forth, all haram. And Allah is guaranteeing you forgiveness. Just turn to Him. Hajj. You know what the reward of an accepted Hajj is? The reward of an accepted Hajj is no less than being as if you were born. Sinless. Sinless. You know what the Prophet ﷺ told us? He said, he who gets up and prays Fajr in Jama'ah, and he stays in that same place where he prayed Jama'ah, and remembers Allah till Shuruq. An hour and a half. He remembers Allah, he reads Qur'an, makes tasbih, sits down, has a lecture or talk about Allah Azza wa Jal. And then after shuruq, he prays two simple rak'at. He will get the reward of Hajj and Umrah completely. But we're the one who turn away. We're the one who are rejecting Allah, His gifts. We're the one who are rejecting paradise. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he who reads Ayatul Kursi after every prayer, nothing stands between him and paradise except for death. Just just read ayat al-kursi after every prayer, you're guaranteed paradise. We're the ones who turn away from Allah. We're the ones who reject paradise. The Prophet ﷺ said that he who wakes up early on a Friday, he makes ghusl and he walks to the mosque and he listens to the lecture properly. Not sitting there playing with his phone or speaking or sitting outside thinking your Friday prayer is accepted when you're outside the mosque. This person will receive 1 year's worship, 1 year's prayer and 1 year's fasting for every step he took to the mosque. But we're the ones who reject Allah Azza wa Jalla. We're the ones who turn away from paradise. The Prophet ﷺ said, he who prays Isha in Jama'ah and Fajr in Jama'ah, it's as if he prayed the whole night in prayer. You could be in your bed snoring, but you got the reward of the whole night in prayer. But we're the ones who spend our time at the movies, or at Salat al-Jama'ah, or at the doggies game, or wherever it is that we're spending our time. The Prophet ﷺ said, he who has perfects his manners, wherever he is, whatever he's doing, is perfecting his manners. He gets the reward of the one who fasts during the day and prays during the night. Can you believe that? I'm not even doing anything extra other than my fara'id, but I have perfect manners. I'm getting the reward as if someone was fasting all day, every day, and praying all day, all night. But we're the one who turned away from paradise. We're the ones who turned away from Allah Azza wa Jal. The tasbih, after the prayer, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told the companions, I'm going to tell you of an action which will guarantee you paradise. And it's so simple, but only little people, only a very small amount of people will do it. So the companions didn't understand. He said, say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, and Allahu Akbar 33 times after every prayer and before you sleep. This guarantees you paradise. It guarantees you paradise from the lips of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And then what do? We don't want paradise, so we don't do it. We don't want Jannah. We reject it. So on the Day of Judgment, we'll reject entering paradise. The Prophet ﷺ told us, every single one of you will enter paradise except he who refuses. He who rejects. So let's stop rejecting. Let's stop refusing. Take the gift of Allah Azza wa Jal. Take the gift of Allah Azza wa Jal. He's given us a way out of everything. Of everything. But we're the ones who choose to swear and sleep around and backbite and cheat and lie. Those brothers who are out in the street sleeping around. Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised you enter, get married and you complete half your religion. Every dollar you spend on your wife and your kids, there is no better dollar spent in any path except better than spending it on your wife and kids. You want to have the best status? The best amongst you is the best who is... There's one who is best to his wives. Look at the na'am Allah has given you in marriage. And then they go and they sleep around. We're the ones who are rejecting paradise. We're the ones who are refusing it. On the Day of Judgment, don't blame anyone but yourself. The shaitan in hellfire, before the barrier is put between paradise and hellfire, he gets up and he makes a statement. The shaitan in hellfire while he's burning and all the people that he dragged into hellfire with him are burning. He gets up and he makes a statement. What does he say? It's mentioned in the Quran. As for the ones who followed Allah, Allah made them a promise and he kept his promise. They're in paradise. Look at them, they're in paradise. And as for the ones who followed me, I made them a promise, but I didn't keep my promise. Look at you, you're in hellfire with me. I had no control over you except to whisper in your hearts. But you listen to me rather than listening to those people who are trying to help you. So don't ever blame me, but blame yourselves. You can't help me or save me, and I can't help you or save you. Everyone will enter paradise except for he who refuses. Look at the shaitan, what he's saying. I didn't have any control. You did it. You listened to me. 1,000 people reminded you, and only me, one shaitan, was whispering to you, and you listened to me rather than listening to them. So don't blame me, blame yourselves. You can't help me or save you, and I can't help you or save you. My dear brothers in Islam, everyone will enter paradise except for he who refuses. Everyone will enter paradise except for he who refuses. Do not be of those who refuse. The simplest action. The scholars say no one will enter the paradise in the hereafter until they enter the paradise of this world. The simplest action. You know what the paradise of this world is? This gathering here. This gathering here. Right now. Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. On the Day of Judgment. The believers and the disbelievers. The righteous and the ones who weren't righteous. All of them will cry screaming out, "Wa ya laytani qaddamtu li hayati. I wish I had done more good deeds." Even the good. I wish I had done more good deeds. Even the good ones. Do you know the Day of Judgment? Me and you, every single gathering that we saw like this, every single time we walk past a gathering like this, we're going to cry blood on the Day of Judgment. We wish we sat for it. Why? Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ gave us the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ gave us the hadith. that Allah Azza wa Jalla has created angels specifically for one job. These angels only have one job. What's their job? To go around the entire earth and look for gatherings like this. When they find gatherings like this, they surround them so much so that they fill the space between the heavens and the earth. Right now, around us, wallahi, thumma wallahi, thumma wallahi, the angels are gathering around us till they reach the heavens. Right now. When they gather around you, Allah sends His peace and His tranquility and His happiness, His contentment in the heart, as we're all feeling right now. Then what happens? They return to Allah Azza wa Jalla when the talk is finished, when the lesson is finished. Where were you, O my servants? O Allah, we're with your servants. And we all know, I mentioned Allah in a gathering and He mentions you in a gathering better than this. So right now, each and every single one of you is being mentioned amongst the angels. Right now, each and every single one of us here, each of us, every single one of our names are mentioned amongst the angels. Where were you? We were amongst your servants. And what did they want? What were they asking for, Allah? They wanted your forgiveness. And what are they asking for, Allah? They're asking for your paradise. And have they seen my paradise? They say, no, Allah. And what would they have done if they had seen my paradise? Ya Allah, they would do everything in their power to make it into paradise. And what do they fear? What are they scared of? They fear your hellfire, Ya Allah. They want to be saved from your hellfire, Ya Allah. And have they seen my hellfire? No, Ya Allah. And what would they have done if they had seen my hellfire? Do you know what the Prophet ﷺ said? You know what the Prophet ﷺ said? If one of us were to see the hellfire, we'd leave our families, our wives, our children, our work, our money, even our toilet breaks. We'll just sit in the mountains and worship Allah till we die so we don't enter it. What would they do if they had seen my hellfire? Oh Allah, if they had seen your hellfire, they would do everything in their power to stay away from it. Everything in their power. You know what hellfire is, my dear brothers in Islam? And sisters, do you know what hellfire is? Can you imagine on the Day of Judgment? Can you imagine on the Day of Judgment when hellfire is brought forth? Not me or you. Not me or you. Prophet Ibrahim, Khalilullah, the close friend of Allah, the one who the Quran mentions as an ummah by himself, will drop to the floor and ask Allah, Ya Allah, you are my friend, please have mercy on me. Prophet Ibrahim, what's going to happen to me and you? If Prophet Ibrahim is on the floor, telling Allah, Ya Allah, you're my beloved friend, please have mercy on me. What's going to happen to me and you? What would they have done if they seen my hellfire? They'd do everything in their power to stay away from it. So Allah Azza wa Jal, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most gracious, the most merciful, Al-Ghafoor Al-Mu'ti, the forgiving and the one who gives with no limits. He makes a statement that I have forgiven the people in this group, I have forgiven them. And granted them paradise and saved them from the hellfire just for sitting in this group. And in another hadith, قُمُوا مَغْفُورًا لَكُمْ. Get up, all of your sins have been forgiven and all your sins have been turned into hasanat. Just for sitting here. Do you see why on the Day of Judgment you'll cry blood that you didn't come to every gathering that you knew of or that you saw or that you walked past? Just for sitting here, Allah Azza wa Jal forgave you all your sins, turned them into hasanat, gave you paradise and protected you from hellfire, just for sitting here. Isn't this a Lord that deserves to be worshipped? Isn't this a Lord that deserves to be worshipped? Yes, this is a Lord that deserves to be worshipped. So the angels say, oh Allah, but there's someone amongst them. He wasn't here for your sake. He might have came, wanted to speak to someone or wanted something of someone. And the shaykh saw the shaykh speaking, so he didn't want to disturb him, so he just sat and listened till the end of the talk, and then at the end he took whatever he wanted of him. This person is not there for your sake. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, I have forgiven him also, and granted him paradise, and saved him from the hellfire, because just for knowing someone who sat in this gathering. Just for knowing someone that sat in this gathering. Every single one of us will enter paradise, except he who refuses. You choose. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.
To listen to or download more Islamic lectures, please visit www.islamicmedia.com.au.